गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. इन आवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट क्राइटेरिया ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ किंगडम एनिमेलिया. सो टुडे वी वुड डिस्कस अबाउट सम टॉपिक्स ऑफ किंगडम एनिमेलिया. इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट सीलम. सीलम इज एक्चुअली अ बॉडी कैविटी एंड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द प्रेजेंस ऑफ बॉडी कैविटी और सीलम वी क्लासीफाई एनिमल्स एज एसिलोमेट्स, स्यूडोसिलोमेट्स एंड सिलोमेट एनिमल्स. एसिलोमेट मीन्स व्हेन देयर इज नो बॉडी कैविटी. दे आर जनरली डिप्लोब्लास्टिक, दैट मीन्स द प्रेजेंस ऑफ ओनली टू जर्म लेयर्स, ओनली आउटर एक्टोडर्म एंड इनर एंडोडर्म लेयर. देयर इज नो मेसोडर्मल लेयर. दे आर सम सेल्स प्रेजेंट इन द मिडल पार्ट, ओके, एंड देयर इज नो मेसोडर्म. So they are generally diploblastic and has two germ layers, ectoderm and endoderm, and they are acelomates. There is no body cavity. Pseudocelomates. Pseudo means they are partially developed. They do have partially developed body cavity. Here you can see this is outer ectoderm, inner endoderm, and this mesoderm has started developing. Okay. So there is partial development of this middle mesodermal layer. Okay. Then we have hemocoelomates, which are quite similar to that of pseudocoelomates, because in hemocoelomates, the true coelom means they are generally triploblastic, ectoderm, mesoderm, and endoderm. All the three germ layers are present. And but in case of hemocoelomates, no doubt they are true coelomic animals, but in case of hemocoelomates, true coelom is reduced. That means it is filled with blood. Means in the mesodermal region, that area is filled with blood. You can see, like you have seen in case of arthropod and mollusks, whitish or greyish type of material is present in the middle part or in the cavity. Eucoelomates, like in chordates, they do have true body cavity. All the three germinal layers are present and they are triploblastic. Why triplo? Three germ layers, ecto, meso and endoderm. Then we have coelom cysocele. Coelom cysocele means there is a cavity which is formed by splitting of mesoderm. The mesodermal, the middle layer, starts splitting, which form a cysocele. So coelom cysocele is formed, or this body cavity is formed after the splitting of mesodermal layer or mesodermal layer, like in annelids, arthropods and mollusks. A whitish greyish type material is formed. And then enterocele, like in case of echinodermates and chordates, in human beings also, it is formed from anteron of gastrula. During embryonic development, one more actually cavity is formed between the mesoderm and the endoderm. This is formed from the anteron of gastrula during embryonic development. Okay, so it's all about coelom, coelomic cavities on the basis of presence of body cavity, acoelomates, pseudocoelomates, partially developed, and coelomates. True cavity, true body cavity. Then excretory system. Excretory system means nitrogenous waste or excretion of or expelling out nitrogenous waste in the form of either ammonia, uric acid or urea. So there are some animals, they expel out their nitrogenous waste in the form of ammonia. They are known as ammoniotelic animals, and if the excretory material is urea, like in case of human beings and higher animals, they are known as ureotelic. And if the nitrogenous excretory waste is uric acid, then these animals are known as uricotelic animals. So on the basis of their excretory material, we have differentiated animals into ammoniotelic, ammonia as excretory product, ureotelic, urea as excretory product, and uricotelic uric acid as excretory product. Okay, the next. Cephalization means the formation of head part or head. So cephalization means concentration of nervous system towards the anterior part, okay, or head formation, like central nervous system. Okay, the network of ganglion and brain. So central nervous system is the example of cephalization, how head is formed. Then the digestive system, either incomplete digestive system or complete digestive system. As you see in case of human beings, there is a full-fledged digestive tract or alimentary canal right from mouth to anus, and in that alimentary canal or digestive tract, organic food is being digested. So animals, on the basis of complete or incomplete digestive system, incomplete means, like you can see in cases of sponges, there is only one opening, means the entry of food particles and exit of or expelling out fecal matter or waste. There is only one opening for that, entry of food and expelling out fecal matter. So they do have incomplete digestive tract, okay, but in case of complete, there is a mouth and there is anus, means there is like a pipe, there is a mouth, there is anus. So entry of food and expelling out fecal matter. So there are two openings in case of complete digestive system. Then we have respiratory system for exchange of gases. So as you know, anaerobic and aerobic. Anaerobic means in the absence of oxygen. Respiration takes place in the absence of oxygen is anaerobic, and in the presence of oxygen is aerobic respiration. So there are different organs, parts of body which take part in exchange of gases in various animals, like body surface. So body surface for the mean of exchange of gases in all lower animals, like in porifera, okay, in cylindrates, like gills in fishes, trachea in arthropods, insects, skin in case of earthworms, and lungs in case of higher animals, including human beings. Nervous system is actually right from, you can say, developing nervous system, reduced nervous system, and highly evolved nervous system, as we see in case of higher animals and in human beings. So it is diffused and scattered cells, like in case of cylindrates. It is like ladder-like structure in case of platyhelminths, ganglia, and there are some few neurons in case of mollusks, and two nerve rings in echinoderms, and the presence of the whole fully or highly developed, highly evolved network of nervous system in case of chordates, higher animals, having CNS and PNS, central nervous system and peripheral nervous system, as we see in case of human being. The spinal cord gets connected with the brain and forms CNS and PNS, central nervous system and peripheral nervous system, in vertebrates. So it's all about the introduction of Kingdom Animalia. So tomorrow we would start discussing about the various phylum, right from the phylum Porifera to Mammalia. Okay, so thank you very much, and do revise properly. Thank you.